let's build over a dozen new shortcuts that you requested, like converting a list in notes to individual reminders, or mark up a screenshot and attach it to a reminder. No Apple Intelligence on your iPhone? No problem. Here's a menu with ChatGPT that you can access anywhere you select text. We're going to build on some of the auto text replies that I did in the last video, so it's just active during a focus mode, plus Notion has some new shortcut actions, and there's new fitness actions in iOS 18.2. Now, the first few shortcuts we're going to build is actually coming from my new community, where you can go to create.beer.fm, and here almost 250 people have already joined just in the last couple weeks. You can start your own discussion post here, and others can comment and like on it. You can submit a shortcut that you're proud of and share it with the community. And if you become a paying member for $5 a month or $50 a year, you have access to my entire shortcuts database, where you can now search it, browse by tag or device. And when you become a member, there's a special place for shortcuts requests, and those get prioritized in these videos. And again, you can join by going to create.beard.fm, and that link's in the description as well. So let's jump into it. So this first shortcut was requested in the community by Tim, and he raises flags every day and wanted to know what status. He raised it up halfway, all the way. And so this shortcut is actually referring to this website. Tim, I hope that's one that actually has accurate listings, but it's updated every day and it basically pulls the text from that homepage of the website to let you know what should be done today. So when you run this shortcut, hit allow the first time you run it, then it will actually show in the quick view whether you should go full staff or half staff. You see the date there just to make sure it's actually timely. And now you can check the flag status daily. Now, Dylan was asking for a shortcut that can convert a list in Apple Notes and then actually create reminders per task. His spouse likes putting it in notes. He likes using reminders. So this shortcut actually has shortcut input here at the top, and it's going to split that text, namely a list, and then each of those items in the list will be used to create a new item in the grocery reminders list. That's it. You'll be able to download this and the other shortcuts in the video description. But now if he and his spouse are collaborating on a list like this in Notes and you have a bunch of things, you can select the full list, then go over to the share option. This contextual menu is getting very crowded. I think this needs a redesign. And if I go all the way over to share, now you'll see that shortcut down here. You'll see Notes List to Reminders is the shortcut name. And if I run that, it's automatically going to create a new reminder per item here. And I already chose the grocery list. You might have to create that. But if I go down to groceries, you'll see there's now an individual item in the grocery list, and that was automatically added through the shortcut. Now, Gabor was asking for a shortcut that automatically got the callback URL for an email message. And unfortunately, there's no shortcut action for this. So instead, what I would recommend is you can do this in Apple Notes or you can do this in Bear. Tap and hold on a mail message here in the stock mail app. You'll see you kind of dragging it around, holding it. Swipe up to go home with your other hand or another finger, then to go to Apple Notes, Bear Notes, or wherever you'd like, and then let go of the mail message, and we'll actually attach it here to the note. It will appear as a hyperlink here in Apple Notes, and now I can tap and hold on it, and I can share the link, and you can create a shortcut if you would want to pull this callback URL. And now wherever you put that link, when you tap it, it'll bring you directly to that mail message in your inbox. All right, Jesse H. from the community was asking to be able to mark up a screenshot, save it to a reminder, but for some reason the markups weren't saving. So he sent me the shortcut he was building, and I just had to tweak it by adding one step. So this shortcut, it waits 1 second, takes a screenshot, opens up the markup action. He did all this himself. The only thing I added was this get images from markup result. For some reason, it was not saving the markups from here. But once you add the get images from, and then in the reminder section, choose to add that image as the attachment here rather than the markup action. And then you'll see a notification to confirm it all happened. And then the marked up version image will be saved in that reminder. So for instance, I just ran it. So it just created this screenshot. I'm going to mark it up by circling something. And remember, you can actually circle something, hold for a second, and it will actually make it kind of a nicer circle. And now when I hit done, it's going to make that into an image, attach the image to the reminder. You'll have to hit always allow the first time. Notification popped up to show that it was done properly. Now let's check our reminder to see if it actually worked. And you'll see that reminder was created in the inbox list and my markups were saved properly. So just add that one action and then your shortcut works great. I'll put a link to download this one in the video description as well. Now Daniel is asking for people who don't have an iPhone 15 Pro or newer to be able to run Apple Intelligence, could you create a shortcut that basically does the same thing? And that's exactly what I have here. This also allows you to share text from anywhere, and then I created a menu option where you can choose how you want to reformat the text. It creates a prompt for ChatGPT depending on your menu option, and then sends it to the ChatGPT app using 4.0, copies it to your clipboard, and also shows you in quick look how it rewrote your text. So I'm actually going to go to a block of text to try and run this. I'll go to the last episode description of Primary Technology, which if you don't know, I have a tech podcast both here on YouTube and you can listen to it wherever you get your podcasts. Primary Technology, links are down in the description. Now, if I select this text, Writing Tools is here because I have Apple Intelligence. But if you don't, now I can go over to the Share menu, scroll down, and the shortcut I called is GPT Writing Tools. If I tap that, now I can choose more professional, more casual, friendly, or concise. Let's go with friendly. It's going to rewrite the text. It'll show it to me in the Quick Look. And there's the preview here in Quick Look of what ChatGPT came up with. And it's also on my clipboard, so I can go down here under the text that I had selected, tap paste, and now I have that friendly text, or I can make it more professional or choose one of the other menu options. All right, next up, I get a lot of requests when we talk about automations like auto texting that you want to do it just on specific days. So I created this shortcut, you can download it below, but this is how you would format an automation to only happen on certain days. So what this does is it formats the current date and does that using this string format, which is all capital E's, and that means it'll return the actual day of the week, the full length word. Then with an if statement, with iOS 18, you can have multiple conditionals to an if statement. So you can do something like, if the formatted date is Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, or Sunday, that was someone's work week, then this automation will do whatever you put underneath it. So if you only want it to automatically text on those days, this is the kind of format you would need in the shortcut. Then otherwise, it will do nothing. You can change these days of the week if you want this to be Monday through Friday, and you can create something similar for times of day. So I just want to have this in the video description for you to download, and you can try playing around with specific day automation programming. All right, this next one, someone requested, can you have a shortcut that basically shows you what photos you took exactly 1 year ago? So this shortcut subtracts 1 year from the current date, and then uses the Find All Photos action, which is really powerful, and it filters by date taken from that adjusted date, which is a year ago. And then it will show those pictures there in the Quick Look. I actually don't know what's gonna come up, so let's see what photos I took a year ago. Oh look, it's the iPhone 15 Pro Max with the Keyway leather case. You could tap this icon here to kind of see them in a list. And here we have a Stanley Cup picture, which I'm just gonna be real, overhyped cup. That's all I'm gonna say. But this shortcut you could download below and see what pictures you took exactly a year ago. All right, next, a new update to the Notion app now brings multiple shortcuts actions and makes them available. Huge win for those who use Notion, especially on their iPhone and iPad. So once you update your Notion app, search for Notion here in the Shortcuts Actions menu, and you'll see all the other options. The other section is kind of dependent on whatever step or note you had open last, but these top four actions will appear all the time. You can add a text box to a page. You can ask Notion AI from a shortcut, create a new document in one of your workspaces, or create a page without opening. I use this first action, add text box to a page, and this is what I'm going to use for Primary Technology because that's where me and Jason actually share our show notes. So it's going to start with a shortcut input that'll pull from the share sheet, whether it's text or URLs, and you can change that here. But I wanted a shortcut where I can quickly add links on the web to our Notion note. And you can expand this menu. You choose your Notion account if you have multiple and your Notion workspace. And then for the page, you can actually specify a specific page. So I can tap there and it will show my most recent pages that I used in Notion. But if I tap and hold on it, I'm actually going to choose Ask Each Time. This way I can just use the same shortcut over and over again and choose the next episode. So now when I'm in Safari looking at an article, if I wanted to add this to the Notion document, I'll hit the Share button right here on the Safari webpage. Here I titled it Add Link to Primary Tech. And when I tap that, now it's actually going to pull up that menu where I choose what Notion document I want to add it to. I'll choose our next episode. And now if I go to Notion, go to that note specifically, and go all the way to the bottom, you'll see it added that link right there. Now you can customize the shortcut if you want like the article title and link to appear, but this is now a great way to add content into your Notion workspace without having to go to the app. And one more for Notion, you can choose to create a new page using their action. So I'll go to the Notion app, let's choose Create Document. For the title, I want it to ask each time, and then for the body of the text, you can have a template or just leave it blank. And I'm going to expand this, I'll choose my Notion account, I'll choose the workspace of Primary Technology, and then for this In section, I'll tap In, and I'm going to put it in the Content Calendar workspace where we keep our new episodes, and then it's going to open it right after. So if I run this shortcut, it's going to ask me, what do I want to title this document? I'll do something like episode 50, hit done. It'll bring me over to the Notion app, and I've created a new document here for episode 50. And it's now in this workspace. The only thing is it goes under the no status option. So you'll have to go there and move it if you would like, but it creates a new document, and it all depends on how you have your Notion set up. Next, in iOS 18.2, we actually get new fitness actions. So if we search for fitness, and you'll only see this on your iPhone, like you won't see this on your iPad or Mac, but if you go to fitness, you'll see you can open fitness settings, you can open your session history, or even go to specific awards or trophy cases. So I did the fitness settings here, and you can choose all settings, or you can go to something specific, like change your goals, health details, units of measure, things like that. If you just do open to all settings, I'll hit play, and it jumps over to the fitness app settings. I'll remove that action. Let me search for fitness again, and maybe I want to go to my trophy case. Well, I can do that. I'll go to all awards, hit play on the shortcut, and there's my trophy case. You can also open to specific awards, workouts, close your rings, things like that. So I'm not sure exactly what people will do with them, but nice to have more actions for built-in Apple apps. All right, these last few were actually automations that were requested, and it's hard to make these downloadable because I like to set them up a lot in the automations tab. So I'll try to go slow, step by step. But this next request was the ability to set a wallpaper when your focus mode changes, but to not change your actual lock screen, home screen setup. And you can definitely do this. When we go to automations, the triggers down here are all the different focus modes. So let's say when I trigger my calm focus mode, we'll say when it turns on, I want it to run immediately, don't notify when run. I'll go next and new blank automation. So whenever the calm focus mode turns on, the next action is going to happen. And so I'm going to search for set wallpaper. I'll tap set wallpaper photo. And here you can customize what changes when calm is turned on. So I'm actually going to tap lock screen and home screen. And this person didn't want the lock screen to change. So I'm going to uncheck lock screen, but keep the home screen. I'll hit done. And then here where you choose set wallpaper, choose the combination lock screen, home screen that you're wanting for this focus mode. If it's your default, then choose your default lock screen, home screen setup. So I'm actually going to choose this last one because this is my default. Basically, it's not associated with a focus mode. So I'm going to choose that, hit done. You can expand it, choose crop to subject and legibility blur. I like to blur my home screen wallpapers. And then right here, it's not letting me pick an image. So the best way I would find to actually set it to a specific image is save that image somewhere in your files. And I'm going to choose file, move that to my first action. And if I tap file here, now I can choose one of the images in my files app. I'm going to choose this kind of sun rising over the earth file, and I'm going to hit open. And now I'll set this wallpaper action to be that file. So when I turn this focus mode on, my wallpaper is going to change to that image, but my lock screen should stay the same. So let's actually test this. Let me go home. I'm going to turn off my current focus, which is actually my filming mode. So now this is what it looks like right now. This is my lock screen. Here's my home screen. So let me go and actually set my calm focus mode, tapping it there. Shortcut will run in the background and you'll see my wallpaper changed right there. And now, unfortunately, my lock screen wallpaper actually went black. I didn't think this was going to happen. So you might need to add whatever wallpaper you like having on your lock screen as a secondary action. So let's actually do that real quick. So now I've added another step for a different file here, and I've duplicated and added a set wallpaper, but this one's going to be for the lock screen. This way it won't be blank. It can change to whatever I'd like. So it's actually gonna be a different image than you see here, but I'm gonna go to my focus mode. And now if I enable the calm focus mode, you'll see the wallpaper changed to that second file I specified, and my home screen is that earth picture. All right, final shortcut. Pablo was asking, I wanna create an automation, auto text, but only in specific focus modes. So let's create a new automation here, and we're gonna choose message as the trigger. For sender, I'm gonna leave it as choose. This way this will apply to anyone. And then message contains, we're gonna do our little hack here and just put a space. So this will reply to any message with a space in it. We're gonna run immediately, go to next. We're gonna go new blank automation, and we're gonna do something that you might have seen before, but we're gonna get current focus. Here, get current focus, that action just sits there by itself. Then we're gonna add an if statement. And for this if statement, this is important, tap where it says icon and change it to name. Now you can actually specify the name of the focus mode where you want this automation to run. So if focus mode is, and let's say filming, because that's actually my current focus mode, now we can add that send message action. And here the send We can choose whatever message. Again, this can be something custom like an out-of-office reply. I'll get back to you soon. And then for recipient, instead of tapping it, we're going to tap and hold on it and choose shortcut input, because this is going to reply directly to the person that sent us the message. So if my current focus is filming, it's automatically going to reply with this message to whoever texts me. But if I'm not in this focus mode, that's the otherwise section, nothing is going to happen. So let's test this out. So I currently am in my filming focus mode. You'll see it there. So I'm going to send a text to myself from a different number, and you'll see that shortcut automation automatically ran, and I got that auto response sent to the person because I'm in that focus mode. But if I turn this focus mode off, and if I send the exact same message, you'll see the shortcut will still run in the background, but it will not reply because I'm not in that specific focus mode. So that's how you can create auto text replies that are only active during focus modes. I hope you find those shortcuts useful. Again, if you join the community, create.beard.fm, and become a paying member, I prioritize the shortcuts that are in that shortcuts request section. Now, I know those auto text replies, others have asked, can I customize it so only when it's a contact, someone I know, and just auto reply to everyone else? I'm gonna try and create that in the next one, but if you ask me down in the shortcuts request in the community, I'll make sure to prioritize that as the first one in the next video. Links to download the shortcuts I built today are in the video description. Don't forget to subscribe before you go and hit that like button. Any questions or leave more requests down in these comments. I do the community requests first, and then I go to the comments and see how many I can build from there. So keep leaving those comments and requesting shortcuts. And if you want to see the last video where I went even more in depth into that auto replying and built a bunch of other shortcuts you requested, check out this video right up here. And if you want to learn more about Apple Intelligence, some of the new features in 18.2 that are coming soon, you can check out this video right up here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.